know, you turn into like a real jerk every time my mother's around. What are you trying to do, impress her?
You're totally out of line, Bernard. You're not mad at him, you're mad at me.
Save that for your patients, Mom.
Some people would say, I don't want to work, or I don't want to work with my mother. I mean, I spend time with her, I grew up with her. Certainly the last thing I want to do is have her tell me what to do in a job situation. Did that bother you, having your mom as a director?
No, it was a completely professional experience for us. I don't live at home anymore. It's not, you know, we don't have that kind of a thing anyway. So no, it was totally professional, you know. A director tells an actor what they want, and the actor tries to please the director. So it really didn't matter who the director was.
Did your mom say that she pleased her?
I think she's pleased. I hope she's pleased.
I think I maybe was afraid, you know. I mean, look at what's happening to, like, Coppola's daughter. They attack her so. So, and in real life, I don't criticize Jason. And as a director, I knew I would have to be critical at times.
I thought that maybe you could coach him a couple of days a week. You see, he never gets a chance to play while his father's around, so Herbert's on tour. I thought that maybe...
Is this a job offer?
Yes. Yes, and I would insist on paying you. What would you consider a reasonable rate?
What are your rates?
I charge $150 an hour.
Fine, I'll take it.
You must be a very good coach.
Do you think this helps your relationship with him as a mom and a son?
Well, I think anything that brings people closer helps a relationship.
It certainly didn't hurt it then.
God, no, it helped
great.
A lot.
Okay. Yeah. Seeing the movie, well, first off, when you read the book, did you read it and say, did you see yourself in the role of the psychiatrist?
Yeah, instantly.
Instantly?
Instantly.
And then what was your next step after that?
Just to find out who owned the book, because I thought that this is a movie that I'd like to make, like to direct.
Lowenstein, you're incorrigible. I mean, here we are at a wonderful restaurant, and you want me to interpret my sister's dreams? You want to interpret dreams? Do mine. I had a great one about you last night.
You had a dream about me?
Yeah. You want to hear?
I'm not sure.
Don't worry, this one's G-rated.
This one?
How do you approach a love scene in front of cameras?
I'm absolutely petrified.
Are you really?
Very, very embarrassed. Because I'm very shy and I'm not an exhibitionist in any way. So I don't like, you know, as you see, I don't like to perform even live in front of people. So I don't like to do a love scene in front of anybody.
How do you feel then? We were just talking about that in the other room and everybody's saying, she's so sweet, she's so nice, and she's a little bit shy. But yet, what people you might read in the tabloids is, oh, she's a tyrant. She takes control. Yeah. And you're not that all.
You see, it's very hard to, I think, put the two images together. In other words, I like to control my work.
Yes.
Because it's like a novelist or a painter, right? I mean, who would control the work? I mean, why shouldn't I put the brush strokes on? Why shouldn't